Hey everyone, today I thought I'd go over the figure eight bend, which is a popular knot used in climbing to join two climbing ropes together. And since it's often used as a lifeline, I thought I'd go over it in a little bit of detail for you. So to tie this one, we just want to start with one of our ropes and tie a loose figure eight, and we'll do that by forming an overhand loop, coming back in underneath the standing part and then tucking the working end back down through that initial loop. And we want to keep that nice and loose. That's our initial figure eight. So once we've tied our initial figure eight, we just want to take our other rope and we just want to follow the path of this knot through, going in the opposite direction and keeping both lines exactly parallel. And when we feed this through, we just want this rope to take the outside radius here rather than the inside radius. And the reason why we do that is it just gives it a little bit of a more favorable bend ratio here, and it makes this knot just a little bit stronger. So we'll keep tracing this knot all the way through and keeping the lines exactly parallel, following all the unders and overs that the initial line takes. And that will be the final knot in its flat form. Notice that it follows the exact path and none of the lines cross. They're parallel all the way through the knot. So to finish this knot off, we just want to dress and set this knot. And we'll do that by first taking these outside bends here and bringing them inwards, and we'll do that by taking them away from these two strands that exit the knot. So to take this outside bend away, we'll just lift that one up and then just pull that in. And then on the opposite side, to take it away from these two strands, that will go down. And we'll also just tighten that up, and to tighten the whole knot up, we just want to take and pull each of these four strands. And you should end up with a nice symmetrical knot with all the strands parallel and symmetrical on both sides. These tail lengths should be a minimum of 200 mil, and you always have the option of finishing off with an overhand stopper on each side, or even a double overhand stopper. And that would be your finished knot ready for use.